Bike maintenance isn't always as hard as you think. So here's 6 maintenance skills that every mountain biker should know. And don't forget to subscribe if you want more advice videos like this in the future. When your existing bike has had new inner cables put in, perhaps an inner cable in your shifter, your once crisp shifting will suddenly start to get sloppy after a couple of rides. Maybe it'll miss a shift, maybe it'll start making a clicking noise before it actually actuates, and this is commonly known as cable stretch. So it's not necessarily that the inner cable has got any longer, but it does mean that the cable has settled into the ferrules and settled into the shifter or the derailleur, and it will become a little bit slack within the outer cable. And this slackness will create sloppy shifting. And it's an easy fix up at the shifter end. Between the shifter and the outer cable is this little dial that should move. And that's what we call the barrel adjuster. If you move it anti-clockwise or away from yourself as you sat on the saddle looking at the handlebar, then that will add tension to the inner cable. So when you're pedaling along, if you've clicked up into a gear, into an easier gear, up the cassette at the back, and it's not quite moving, it's just making a clicking noise, that means it's trying to move up into a gear, and you need to dial this to add some tension so that it moves up. So you can do this while you're pedaling, and if it moves up into the gear, then success. Try adding one click at a time to add your tension. And if you start going up into your easiest gear and coming back down and you find that that's a little bit of a struggle, it might be that you've added a little too much tension and you just want to back it off going clockwise or back towards you if you're sat in the saddle. And just make sure you cycle through the gears and check it all works. If this hasn't worked for you, then you might want to take it home and check it in a stand and check out Doddy's more in-depth video to see what the problem might be. If your disc brakes are rubbing, the easiest way to diagnose the problem is to put your bike over a light-coloured surface so that you can look down your calipers and see the gaps between your discs and your pads. If your disc doesn't look like it's in the middle and there's rubbing more on one side than on the other, it's probably that your caliper is misaligned or it's been knocked out of line. Now, this is an easy fix, and all you have to do is adjust the bolts that attach the caliper to your bike. The easiest way to fix this is to loosen off both bolts, maybe just a little bit, just a quarter turn or half turn, and then squeeze the correct brake so that it moves the caliper into the correct position, and then re-tighten up the bolts while the brake is still being squeezed. And that should fix it. If that hasn't centered it and there's not an even gap between either side of the disc, you might have to do it by eye. So just loosen off those bolts a quarter or a half turn and start to move and manipulate the caliper until you can see an even gap either side. Don't rotate the wheel, don't move it, because a moving disc is quite dangerous. It's got holes and sharp bits that could pull your finger in. And I would advise tightening either bolt up just a tiny bit either side so that the tightening doesn't actually move the caliper as well. Hopefully, as you start riding, this should have solved the problem. But if you notice it's still rubbing or the problem persists, then you might want to check out our more detailed video to see if there is a problem with your pistons, and the link's down below. If your brakes are rubbing, but the noise is a bit more intermittent, this is possibly because you've bent or warped your disc rotor, and you can re-straighten that with a truing fork, or if you don't have one of these, you could possibly use some needle-nose pliers or even an adjustable spanner. Either way, try to avoid touching the disc because the oils from your hands could contaminate the rotor, and it's quite dangerous to touch them anyway. Or you could use some nitrile gloves to protect them. So I like to spin the wheel until I hear that scraping noise. So I can hear that scraping noise every time these spokes come through past the caliper. So I know that the bend is somewhere around here. And if you look down the caliper, I can actually see that the disc is towards me too much. So I'm going to use the truing fork to move it back towards the wheel. You may know how to get a tire off a wheel, but sometimes a tire and a wheel combination can be really tight. And sometimes sealant can stick the tire to the shelf on the inside as well. So my best tip for you is to let all of the air out, whether you're tubeless or tubed, and to get the bead of the tire right into the center of the rim. Now this is the smallest circumference of the wheel, and so it should loosen up the tire enough to get your levers in and lever it back out again. Same for when you're putting the tire back on. Get all of that bead into the center as much as possible so that when you come to the end of the tire, it should be in its shortest diameter and you should be able to lever that tire back into place. Handy tip is to always use plastic levers so that it doesn't damage your rims, and use two as well. Put them both in at the start and then lever one at a time so that when it becomes tight, you've still got your second one already in there to lever it out. Bonus tip for you here, if your tire is now too loose to pump it up in your tubeless setup, then you're gonna need to shock it into place and shock it onto that shelf. So the best thing to do is to use something like a CO2 canister or a rechargeable tubey booster like this, or if you're lucky enough to have one built into your pump, then you're gonna need to charge it up and inject it with some high volume air. If you've got a tubeless setup and you're out on a ride and you get a puncture, but the sealant doesn't seem to be sealing, that's fine. Sometimes the holes are too big for the sealant to seal and you're gonna have to use a tire plug like these. So the best thing to do is to find the hole. So I found mine here and try and use a tire plug that is about a similar size. Okay, so we're gonna take our plug, which is roughly the same size as the hole because it's gonna go through your plugger and it will eventually double over in size in the hole. So get your pointy end, careful, it's quite sharp, and manipulate it into the tire. Give it a little wiggle. And then pull the plug back out. And this should be doubled over in there. Try inflating it, and if that seals, then you've done a good job and you can cut these ends off afterwards. Now we cut this end off just so that it doesn't get ripped out of place when you're riding back home. And it's a good idea when you do get back home is to add a little bit of glue on the inside and the outside of the tire around that plug just to make it last a little bit longer. Changing the pads for your brakes should be the easiest part of maintaining your bike. All you have to do is, once you've got the correct pads for your model of brake, is to work out how they come out. Now, most brakes are held in by a pin at the top, and some are held by magnets, but usually there is a pin. And all you have to do is remove this pin, take the pads out, and put your new ones back in the same way they came out. Some of them are directional. They might be labeled L and R, so they need to be on the left and the right as the bike is upright. Some will come out from the back, but either way, it's a good idea to take note of how the pads came out so that you can match them when you put the new pads going in. These Shimano pads come with a little clip that just goes around the braking surface on both sides. make sure it's in place, so it's at the back, and then work out your right and your left. So left on the left side, and we push them in. Go gentle with the pin when you're putting it back in. This doesn't need torquing up, it just needs nipping up gently. And once you've got everything back in place and your wheel back in place, you're going to need to bed those new pads in because they won't work great from the outset. So take yourself to a hill, a road or a fire road, get up to speed down the descent and apply the brakes gently but firmly all the way back a couple of times, and that should heat them up and get them grabbing again. So hopefully now you can do all of the maintenance basics on your mountain bike, but if you've struggled with any of the sections, then we've left some more detailed videos linked down in the description below, so you can watch those for more information. And if you want more advice like this in the future, don't forget to subscribe.